Let me show you how to find our MegaLog function. You go into our menu, you scroll down until you can find MegaLog function, and then you have different opportunities. You have the opportunity to put an SD card into the machine, and then you can log all data you need. That means you can take them out, put them into a computer if that's what you want, so you can see if the amps is okay compared to maybe a WBPS welding procedure specification. So in this case, we don't need that. I have just made a weld, 100 millimeters, and I want to find out, okay, what is my heat input into my material? You go into the MegaLog function here, and then the machine has saved all data from the last weld. I put in my millimeters of the length of the plate or the weld, 100 millimeters, accept it, and then it calculates my heat input up here. And then you can see if it's too high or if it's too low. Everything is in here, so also if you have to make a calculation for a company, you have given an order, and then you need to find out, okay, how much time does it take to make a given order, or how much gas do I need? How much wire do I have to use? So all data is in the machine. If you want to make a calculation, the easiest way to do it is to use this trip function. Then you can make a weld, it could be 100 millimeter, and then you can see the arc time, you can see the wire, how much wire did you use, and the gas consumption. And then you can calculate your task to your customer. If you're welding with modified arc types, you can go into this, and then you can go down to choose your type of arc energy. That means you have the opportunity to make instantaneous, which are used for especially the modified arc types. If that's what one, then we have a different types of calculation. So it measures much faster compared to the average way of doing it. If you don't want that, you can just take the old way of doing it, and then it calculates automatically. Your choice. I'll just go to the instantaneous, go back, and then we're back to the menu.